Welcome to another glorious episode of Someday I'm going to need to name this channel, I think. What we're doing today, we're welding the bedsides. We cut them last time from long bed, cut the 20 inches out of it. We're going to be welding them so they're short bed. So let's get started and let's see how much we can get done today. So next step is grinding all the paint off so that we can weld. The next thing that we're going to do after that is we're going to use the perfect panel prep tool from Eastwood. They've been marketing the hell out of this thing. So I figured, why not try it? It makes sense. Ideally what this does, you put the metal in, pinch down on it, and then what it does is it folds the edges in so that you have a little valley to weld in, less to grind away. You actually leave more weld material there because of the valley that it creates. So that's the concept. We're going to see how well that works. I've done it on a couple test panels and it seems like it works pretty well. So we are going to give that a shot. Run into a couple places where there's been previous repair. You can see some body filler there as well as a hole. And when we come to this side, same thing on top. Not a big deal, but it's there. As you can see, this leaves a nice little ridge so that weld can really sink down into that and get the metal just right. Okay, getting everything lined up, getting ready to tack it in place. Quick pointer. So the only two straight edges that really you need to care about, three really, is right across here, and something right in the middle. I mean, obviously, you're going to use magnets and get everything as close as possible. We're going to get it tacked. Tacking this up now. We got magnets on. You saw kind of the dressings on the side. You're probably wondering what's going on there. I'm going to be using flux core, not shielding gas. So that splatters everywhere. So just hoping that protects the paint a little bit and it kind of keeps the grinding down to a minimum. What we're going to be using is the Hobart Handler 140 MIG welder. Just got it. I was playing with it the other day. It's pretty legit. It's 115 volts, so you can plug it in any outlet, which is pretty neat. I like that. Our settings that we're going to be using with the flux core, it's 0.030. So that's where we are. We're going to get this one tacked, and then I think I'm going to start prepping the other one a little bit more and go from there. If you haven't done this and you're curious or you maybe didn't know this, 18 gauge sheet metal, so it's really thin. You're not going to be running beads on it. It's just tack, move 6 or 8 or 12 inches up, tack, move up, tack, let it cool. This sheet metal is going to warp like crazy if you try and put too much heat into it. The paint also may, and the surrounding area may bubble. So don't do that.
I don't want to say I learned that the hard way. I looked it up, I seen it on videos, but doing on a test panel there, definitely saw how it bubbles, so it definitely makes sense to do that. Yeah. I feel after getting into these bedsides, I don't really feel like there's any pressure in terms of, you know, making this right or making it even perfect, because as I'm diving into them, pulling paint off of it, cutting them, they're definitely in rough shape. So they're a lot better than most, but the paint's not perfect on them, so we're gonna try and salvage what we can. Ultimately, I don't think we're gonna be painting this truck anyway, but like it to be smooth, we may do a wrap on it. So, tacked it. Ultimately, the flux core just has to burn too hot for it to be feasible. So I'm gonna have to get a tank tomorrow, and I'll just get regular wire, probably 025, 023. The 030 flux, like I said, it's just burning right through. So not counterproductive. They are attached. They are together. But I'm not making the progress that I should for the amount of time that I've been out here. So that's what I'm going to have to do. I'm going to have to go get one tomorrow or something. It's already pretty late. Go from there. I say that all the time. But that's the plan. So we'll see when I get that tank. Okay, let's try this again. Back at it today. I got shielding gas. If you can see, just a little bottle. That's a number 2. I think it's 40 cubic feet, 75% argon, 25% carbon dioxide. I have no concept of how long that's going to last me, but based on just doing spot welds and how much wire I have left just from what I've done plus practicing, I think that's going to be more than enough. I didn't have any context what that was even going to cost, so maybe if you're a beginner welder like myself, the context I'll give you, one, how long does it last, and two, that bottle, which you had to buy, was $230. And the gas refill each time is going to be $36. And I think you just exchange the tank at that point. So kind of a bigger upfront investment, but hopefully something that doesn't become a drag moving forward. I've got a decent amount of welding to do on this truck in terms of body work underneath, cab corner, things like that. So we'll see how it goes. I'll keep you updated, but that's where we're at from there. Today, what we're going to do, I'm trying to decide, do we continue welding or do we take, I don't have a lot of time today, or do we take these end pieces off? So let's start with the end pieces and kind of see where we're at. Kind of learning from my mistakes in terms of the burn through that I was getting. One, the flux core, we had to burn way too hot. Two, I should have put a piece of scrap metal underneath to help absorb. So I have scrap metal, but it's difficult to get under there, I believe. So I did order a copper spoon. Again, for beginner welders who maybe don't know what that's for, that's going to absorb a bunch of heat to prevent blow through. Also, the weld won't stick to the copper, so that's something that you just pop right off, and especially for some of the bigger gaps that we do have. We're definitely going to want that so that that puddle kind of sits across there and spans the gap and still fuses the metal. Oh, what else? It's been crazy getting all of this over the course of several days. So this video is probably going to be longer. I would imagine, I'm sure once I edit it, we'll know. But let's get started doing something. I'm just gonna see what we get done. And eventually it'll all get done and it'll all be done. Because I'm doing the other one, but don't put your arm behind it, because if that bit slips off, it will get you and it hurts. So luckily not deep, not bad, but just safety precaution. Everything you learn the hard way, I guess. So I'll be right back. Never thought I'd actually need that first aid kit, but I'm glad I have it. Stupid mistake. Anyway, moving forward. Passenger side is off too. Didn't come off quite as clean as the other one, but nothing the grinder won't fix up there. But yeah, same thing, 23 spot welds on that side too, so get after it. Magic like I'm rocking a cape in the room. Mental patient escape from the room. Now I'm out the basement, head straight for the moon. And it might be some black shit, but I feel like I'm radioactive. I would give myself a C+ on this. I could have spent a little more time lining things up before, would have made that a little bit easier. And unfortunately, with some of the metal being as thin as it was, it's not going to look quite as pretty as it should, but still plenty of finish work to do. It won't be that bad. Got it ground down pretty good. There's a little bit more to do there. Body filler, primer, and yeah, a lot of sanding. So I'm not going to repaint these panels. I'm just going to leave the primer stripe on there. So it doesn't have to be perfect. It's going to be pretty obvious that it's a long to short bed conversion. So I have this one done. There's still a little bit more work to do over on the passenger side one, but it's close. So we'll worry about that later. I probably won't show that on film just because this video is already long enough as it is. Next time what we're going to do is we're going to get the end pieces put on. We're going to start that project, so hopefully have that done by the weekend, so we shall see. Other than that, So far so good. We're moving forward as always. So stay tuned. We'll keep rocking and rolling on these bedsides. So see ya.